So this striped bass here is probably somewhere between 1 and 2 years old. Telltale sign to tell what a striped bass looks like is these long stripes that go from his head to his tail. In the Chesapeake Bay, they tend to call these fish rockfish because of their stripes. They're nicknamed stripers up north, but when they come into the Chesapeake Bay, they begin to migrate towards areas of structure where you get a lot of shelter and a lot of refugia for them to both forage in, as well as for them to seek shelter from predators. One unique feature of juvenile striped bass is they're very dark on the top while they're light on the bottom. And what that does is for any kind of a bird predator, he's gonna blend in with a darker bottom. Any predators coming from below him, he would blend in with that sky, a little bit like the sky that we have today. This fish is about 22 inches long and somewhere between 4 and 5 years old. In Maryland, Virginia, and the Potomac River Fisheries Commission alone, there are over 600,000 licensed recreational anglers. But whether it's a big trophy fish in the spring or fall, or even some of these more summertime autumn fish like this, it would be a good choice for them. This is one of the keystone and top couple species that we have to offer in the Chesapeake Bay, and it creates a sense of stewardship for the Chesapeake Bay that we need to make sure that we're able to develop more over the years, and with, you know, people to come and anglers and fishermen to come. The Chesapeake Bay is equally as important to this species as it is to us. Without the Chesapeake Bay, potentially could lose over 70 to 90% of the spawning stock of striped bass. A strong majority of these species are actually born and raised here, so it's something for us to protect and to make sure that they have the habitat that they need.